Quite a while, as you've heard. We have holiday music from different religions, different cultures, vastly different centuries even. We have some music that the melody dates back to the mid-1500s, and then we have stuff from only a couple decades ago. So we're really all across the map here, but that's the way we like to do it here and to have all kinds of repertoire represented. You'll hear solos, you'll hear choral music, you'll hear piano solo works. So there's a lot on the menu tonight, and you might even get a chance to participate later on. More on that later. For now, we're going to move ahead with the next piece in our concert, which is a stylistic departure from the first two, but I hope you enjoy. Thank you. reveal that the next number will feature Paul Serpine, our MC and guest instrumental soloist, playing the clarinet part. So thank you very much. If you hadn't figured that out, you would see walk over with it.
Thank you. One of the unique things about Greater Milford Community Chorus and a tradition that goes back many decades with the chorus is they give the opportunity to members of the chorus to audition during each concert cycle to do a solo during the concerts. And you don't find that in choruses all over the place, but it's kind of a Milford thing. And a really nice one. Tonight's first solo performance is going to be brought to you by Mr. John Goulart. It's a song called Snow. John first performed this piece 20 years ago as a member of the Bridgewater State University Alumni Chamber Choir. And he has sung this solo over the years and always comes it when the snow first starts to fall, wherever he may be from. You know, if he's in traffic or wherever. So the piece is a poem set to music with lyrics based on snowflakes by Henry Wadsworth Longfellow. And John says he doesn't want to be held responsible if it snows tonight, anytime during a solo or after while you're trying to get home. But it would be kind of cool if it did, I think.
Snow is falling, snow.
Thank you, John, for that really beautiful addition to the concert. The next song is called When a Child is Born, and it features, as the vocal soloist, Mr. Peter Black.
Thank you. Steinbach/war. It sounds like a waffle. Thank you.
Descant solo was performed by Carly Alden.
Okay.
The next number we'll be performing for you tonight is from the film, actually, Sister Act 2. Yes, that's right. And it will feature, as vocal soloist, Gina D'Ottavio.
Thank you.
The next piece that we'll be performing this evening is the Wexford Carol. The Wexford Carol is a very old traditional Christmas carol. This arrangement is newer, it's 20th century. So it's arranged by Richard Leakey. And it's a very, very beautiful Christmas carol, a very haunting feel to it, but in a very sort of, a very positive way, not in the bad connotation of that word, but it really sticks with you once you hear this carol. And this is an arrangement that features a vocal solo, and the vocal soloist is Lisa Mather. All right, so we have reached that portion of the evening, which I alluded to earlier. You all get a chance to participate. So, yes, that's right. Someone said yes. That's correct. Right. So if you look in your program, you will find lyrics to just a few Christmas tunes. And we are going to be singing them, of course, and you are more than welcome, encouraged to join along. You probably know some of these words by heart anyway, but we put them in there just to be nice. So please join us in our holiday singing.
What I see.
a lot of strong voices coming from the audience. Voices that I think would be great to have up there. And, you know, we're always looking for new members at the Greater Milford Community Chorus. We are starting our spring season. Well, as you heard earlier tonight, this concert, this holiday concert this December marks the end of our 50th year. Half a century of singing beautiful choral music here in Milford, which is really something very special. So as we bring that to a close and we look forward to our 51st year, we are happy to have new people come in and check us out. I do feel it's important to note that the first few rehearsals, three rehearsals, next check, are sort of trial, drop-in, no commitment necessary. So starting Monday, January 8th, in the evening, we rehearse at Memorial Hall, which is right down there. You can see it, basically. In the evening, we rehearse, and you're welcome to come, check us out, drop in. If you're not free on the 8th, come by the following week, and just see if this is something you want to do. If you used to sing, but it's been a long time, or maybe you've never sung before, but you really want to, we're happy to welcome people at any experience level. You don't need to know how to read music. We'll teach you the songs, and you'll learn as part of being in the group. You'll pick up a lot along the way. So there's no audition in that sense. But think about it. If you just sang those songs with us and thought, I want to do more of that. I want to do that in harmony. I want to do that in another language. No, they don't all have to. We do a lot of English performance. But we push our boundaries too. So if you're interested, consider coming to sing with us January 8th. Now we have a couple other, we have one more thing to perform for you tonight. Before we do, I just want to acknowledge and thank some more people without whom we would literally not be able to perform this concert for you. Our wonderful musicians collaborating with us, we have Robert Orr in the bass. David Byer on percussion. And of course, our very own accompanist, Wayne Ward. And we want to thank you for joining us and making music with us tonight. Thank you very much. We have one more selection, and it will be familiar to, I think, perhaps everyone. Thank you for coming out.